3, 2, 1. What's up, guys? This is Board Game Roamer, and I am here with another unboxing of a new game. Just came out called Stuff Fables. It is by Plaid Hat Games, a game by Jerry Hawthorne. It's an adventure book game. This kind of caught my radar because I did like Mice and Mystics. I know there's a lot of... Seems like you either love Mice and Mystics or you hate Mice and Mystics, but I personally like Mice and Mystics, and this looked pretty neat. I feel like thematically, this might actually, for younger gamers that are kind of trying to get into gaming and you want to introduce them to this idea of the story and progression and that sort of thing, I think this will do it well. Watch It Played has done a playthrough video, rules explanation video as well. But it just caught my eye, and so I'm looking forward to it because I think it is a little bit different from Mice and Mystics. You do have the storybook, but in this, you know, you're playing with the book on top, and I don't know, it just looked neat. So I've already taken the shrink off. I have not opened the box itself, so let's take a look at the box and see what we've got. We got a heavy box. I think it was 5.5 pounds, so it's not light. Let's see here. Discovery Deck Story 1. This is the Discovery Deck. Do not rearrange or look. These cards are arranged and divided into stories. Each story in the storybook will instruct players to collect discovery cards. Okay, so we don't need to change the order of the deck. So here's the rule book. So let's take a quick look at the rule book here. Looks like a good bit of pictures, points of interest, attribute dice, how to move, glossary. Okay, so the rule book is simply attacking the boss, that's cool. Targeting minions, defending, etc., etc. Cool. So it's 15 pages. Really, we'll call it 13. There is not a turn order thing in here, though, so that's kind of... I really like when they have those, like, on the back where you can read it. Leave that out. Then we got a cardboard here. And actually, is that the only set of cardboard? I think that's the only set of cardboard. Hold on a second. Yeah, that's the only set of cardboard. So you got your... hearts, which is basically like how you do your special abilities, the enemy tracker, some special tokens for certain scenarios, and stuffing, which is kind of like your life, I guess, in a way. First player marker. So not a whole lot of tokens, just a handful of tokens. And then you've got, oh, this is the good stuff. The storybook. Holy crap. I'm going to be honest. I did not realize how thick this thing is. This dude is thick. And it comes with 7 stories. First story starts on page 3. The last story starts on page 83. So there is a lot of story in here. But I'll just show you right quick. When you start, you're going to have a story. That it's going to read to you, and then it's going to tell you specifically what to do. But at some point, you'll start, and this will be the room. So you'll have this laid out. You're going to be playing on this side, and then all of the things that happen are going to be over here. They've also included these QR codes that actually match Watch It Played, Rodney Smith's videos, for this specific action and or this specific point set up or specific action or a specific symbol or something like that, what those mean. These QR codes actually will take you to his site to that specific point in his videos. So cool. So you got, wow, 83. You got a bunch of pages of that. And you got different story endings. Cool. Nice. That looks really neat. It's a big, thick book. I really can't believe it's that thick. Then we've got our hero cards. You're one of six stuffies. I believe it's six. You can be Theodora, Stitch, Piggle, Lumpy, Lionel, or Flops. And they all have different abilities. Flops has dodge, leap, perfect agility. Theodore has resourcefulness, persevere, words of motivation. You can save dice. This is where you store the hearts that you can use to activate this, and where you have your stuffing and a max amount of stuffing. Like I said, that's kind of like your life. Everybody's looks the same, but their abilities are all different. Cool. All right, and then we've got a draw bag, which is for the dice. So what you do is you take all these dice, each color of dice, blue. Well, I can't remember the colors because like the pink is really not pink; it's something else. But each color dice has to do with either movement, or attacking, or something. Enemies, what you know, basically one that's wild. As you put all these in this draw bag, and you shake it up. And you pull out, I think it's like five on your turn or three. You put out some number of dice, and then that's basically on your turn. That's the things that you can do. You use those dice to move or attack or whatever. And then when you're done with your turn, you put them all back in the bag, shake them up. And then the next player will actually go in and pull out five dice. So everything goes back in the bag at the end, generally, as far as I know. All right, and then you got these buttons. These are... don't really, color of the button doesn't matter, but these are kind of like special tokens that will let you do things. You can use these to trade. You can use these to do special actions. And you get those for beating, defeating enemies, I believe. And then, here we have a bunch of miniatures. Holy cow, that's a bunch of miniatures. And some of these are really big. Yeah. It's actually really, really big. Nice. Very nice. The other cool thing here is that you've got... let me just kind of give me a second to set these up. Yeah, so... so all those are the same. That's not the same. Those are the same. I believe these are our heroes. Yep, that's a hero. It's not the round bases. Nope. I was going to say the round bases are the heroes, but that's not true. Not completely. Okay, yeah. So basically all the enemies, and I'll just show you an example here of what happens in the first story. So you have these different shape bases, and you have different cards that come out for them, so that even though they all look the same, that's how you tell which card to put out, and their abilities and whatnot. And certain abilities will say, you know, all the circle bases do this. Maybe you're... Oh, goodness, I wanted to sneeze. All the circle bases or square bases do this. So that's how you tell, or maybe I could be wrong. It may just be that's how you tell who does what on the cards. But those bases are different, and there's one, two, three different type monsters, basic monsters. And then there's a number of bigger kind of mini bosses. I'll just show you the first one that you come to, which is this monkey, monkey guy. So, and there's, so there's five of those, and then of course you've got all your heroes. Now, just to give you a size comparison. Lionel, excuse me. This is Lionel. He's a hero. This is one of the bad mini bosses. So These guys are going to be a little bit bigger and a little bit tougher, but that's okay. All right, story one, Discovery Deck. I guess this is the. So you have the story deck, which different things happen in the story deck. We're not going to open that because it just said this is a Discovery Deck. Do not rearrange or look at these cards. These cards are arranged and divided. Each story and storybook will show. Okay, so. This is going to go through the story. So I'm not going to call this a legacy game per se, because there is a bit of random because of the items and what you draw out of the bag or whatnot. But of course, you could make the same argument for Mice and Mystics, but I love playing Mice and Mystics. I played all those scenarios a number of times, and that was okay with me. So you got different. Let's see here. Let's take a look at these cards, though. I think these are cards that we can look at. So you have, these are kind of like event cards, I think, sort of. That's the bad. Let's get these kind of broken out here. Seems to be more of the same. Nope. Me just go ahead and open these, this other pack and get it ready. Come on now. You can do it. There we go. Right, here we go. Attribute dice. Yes, we'll definitely talk about that. Okay, so this is like the item deck. So you have you can get items in different ways. Ooh, put this over. We'll leave this in there. You can get items in different ways, and these different items will give you additional dice, basically like to roll when you're attacking. Some may be defense, some may be weapons, some may be armor. Like that's the head space, the hand space, miscellaneous stuff. Trying to see if there's like a. There's a lot of miscellaneous. I don't want to show too much of this because I want you guys to find out about it for yourself. Looking to see. It seems like there was a. See if there's like a two-handed weapon. So you've got all these item cards, and like I said, they're all they can be associated with either a specific die that maybe adds something to. So this adds like +2 bonus when searching for or performing yellow skill tests, add 2 to yellow dice results. So it's gonna let you get better results on a dice, maybe reroll dice or even add additional dice. So that's what the item cards do. Then you have these cards are, I guess for lack of mood cards, maybe is the best way to put it. I don't, during the playthrough, what would happen was, at different points, the story will ask you to draw one of these cards, and as long as she doesn't wake up, right, which is this one right here, then you're okay. But whether she's sleeping peacefully or maybe restless, may change the story in some shape, form, or fashion. Whatever the last one drawn, it's going to change the story a little bit. So that's cool. I do like that. Let's see here. Then you got all right. So here's all the bad guys. So Crawley. So here's the four Crawleys, right? And you can see there's a leader. It's kind of hard to see there. It's got a circle down there. And then the next one's got the square base. Right, so what you'll do is you'll have these kind of in a stack and you'll pull out one and lay it down beside the track, and then you'll find the appropriate base for that baddie and put it on the board. So that's how the baddies work. And again, there's a different one. Excuse me. There's a different one for each one of the three monster types. Okay, and then we've got leap spaces, hiding spots. Oh, so I think these are cards. Not really sure what these are. Water, darkness, low visibility, walls. I think these are telling you how this, yeah, this is telling you how it works on the board, the different types of tiles. So you have a basically reference cards here for that. I know that's kind of hard to see. You also have the player turn order here. So you got, draw dice, find stuffing, place threat, perform actions, or you can move, reserve, encourage, test skills, group task, attack, search, discard dice, check threat. So, and then on the back of that tells you what each. So red is strength and lets you do melee attacks. Green lets you do ranged attacks. Yellow are search, perception. Yellow slash perception, so searching for things. Blue resistance, that's defense, and then the purple is a wild color, so you can use it for any of those. This is a little bit of a telling you what those are for right there. And we talked about those, and then we've got these cards. Basically, again, I'm not going to show it to you. You have a question, so I'll give you a scenario, and it gives you a choice. Do you want to do X or Y? And depending on which one you pick, it may just give you something. It may not give you anything. It may lead to an additional, test that you have to make. And then depending on whether you pass it or fail it, you may or may not get something. So it's a good way to add a little bit of randomness. Having said that, that is why I think it's two players, because this really, you don't want to know what, when you ch make your choice on these, you kind of want to not know. But at the same time, once you play this through enough times and you see these cards, because there are some duplicates of a few of them, like this Meek and Muddled. Let's see here. Oh, no. Some will have the same name, but they have different outcomes. Cool. So, yeah. I don't know how you do that. Let's single player. But that is neither here nor there. So yeah, that's actually all there is. Not a whole lot of components, which is good. But man, I'm telling you. And this is good. This is good, thick, glossy, really nice board here. So there's all your heroes there. So yeah, we'll definitely want to try to give this a go. This may be a little bit harder for me to do because I really would need two people to do it, but I have some friends in mind that I think would like to do that. So yeah, that is Stuffed Fables, again by Plaid Hat Games, and they're calling it an adventure book game. Really cool game. I think you should check it out. Definitely check out Rodney Smith's How to Play and his playthrough with Pep. And they play through maybe the first chapter, I think. Maybe even not all the way through that, but it gives you a good idea of how the game goes and how the game flows. So definitely check that out. Thank you guys for watching this unboxing video, and I will see you, ladies and gentlemen, in the next video. Bye, guys.